Hello and welcome to part 3 of my Left 4 Dead 2 mapping tutorial series. Setting up boundaries is essential for any video game, but it's especially important for Left 4 Dead 2 seeing as there are two teams, the survivors and the infected, the latter needing access to safe areas away from survivors to spawn in. We can create these safe areas and prevent players from getting to spots we don't want them with the clipping tool textures. Luckily, unlike the prior two videos in this series, clipping is easy. But before we get into it, it's important to note you'll always want to make your clip brushes before making a navmesh. I'll go over navmeshes in the next video, but just remember that. To block off both teams from an area, simply make a brush with the tool's clip texture. No player or bot, survivor or infected, will be able to go through this brush. Bullets and grenades can still pass through, same with attacks from ranged infected. As said in the intro, the infected team frequently has access to areas that are off-limits from the survivors, so they can safely spawn. These off-limits areas need brushes with a clipping texture placed to prevent survivors from getting in. Take this area on my demonstration map that should only be accessible to infected. To make the clip brush, create a brush with the tool's player clip texture. This texture blocks only survivors, so infected can move freely within it. There's a third clipping texture that blocks only the infected team. However, usage of this texture for a serious map is questionable, as typically all areas you want to block infected should also block survivors. In Valve maps, there are wrong way signs that show when an infected player is close to a boundary. These are manually placed in Hammer in two ways. First is a brush, second is a model. Let's go over the brush first. Make a brush with the no-draw texture. Turn that brush into a brush entity with Ctrl plus T and change the class from funk underscore detail to funk underscore brush. Funk brush can do many things, like have no collision, move, accept inputs, etc. Think of it as the prop underscore dynamic of brushes. By default, it has the settings we want, which is no collision. Next, texture the side you want to be the wrong way sign with the tool slash wrong way texture. This will appear only to infected in-game like we want. Using a wrong way model is a little simpler but less modular. Make a prop underscore static and choose a wrong way model. Disable the model's collisions and set a start fade distance of 600 and an end fade distance of 800. Clipping can also be used in ways more than just limiting player movement. If you have a bunch of small props sticking out of a wall, it would be annoying to get snagged on them. So we can cover the props with the tool's clip texture to smooth out the movement. Pressing the CM button at the top shows the collision models for all the props. A classic use case of clipping is to clip stairs. Watch how going upstairs looks without clipping. Now watch with clipping. Big difference. This concludes part 3 in my Left 4 Dead 2 mapping tutorial series. Next one is huge. We'll be getting the navmesh working, meaning bots will follow you and zombies will start spawning. Stay tuned, and thank you for watching.